Monday night, Ric Flair will have to make a choice. Will he align himself with Team Package, or will he stay with his best friend of over 20 years, Arn Anderson?
Well, I tell you, knowing Flair as much as I do, and it's not all that much because he's in a different plane, I would suspect he might hide behind the massive shoulders of the Total Package.
The Mamalukes have been in the crosshairs of the Harris boys as of late. Not only will they do battle at Uncensored, but the Harris boys have had a plan for the World Tag Team Champion. They have been spreading out the green stuff all around. Tag teams left and right have been buying new Rolexes and new watches money from the Harris boys.
Hey, listen up, man. We got a lot of things going on. NWO girls are driving us crazy. You got this thing with the Mamalukes tonight. Don't want to earn a little bit of extra money?
Here you go, guys. Take it off.
Hey, really beat the hell out of these guys for us tonight. I mean, pound them, okay?
You got it.
All right,
there
man.
You go.
Well, that certainly explains the Cadillac Escalade that I saw Scott and Steve Armstrong driving around in.
Well, the Armstrongs aren't stupid. I mean, no. Professional wrestling. Someone hands you money, take it.
They did.
Was that cash?
I guess.
Don't claim it.
Well, I didn't hear that.
Of course you didn't.
Didn't hear that at all. Scott and Steve Armstrong. Armstrong Brothers.
Hey, come here, guys.
Come here, guys. Come here.
What's up, man?
All right.
What's up, man?
Hey,
we got a lot of crap going on.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So y'all got this thing with the Mamalukes stuff?
Yeah, the Mamalukes.
I know you always want to earn
that. You got the money, man. You got the money.
Hey, take care of the Mamalukes for us tonight.
Hey, man.
Eat them up.
Get the job done.
Get the county guy.
All right.
Done, maybe J.C. Ice and Wolfie D can get a couple of decent haircuts with the money funneled to them by the Harris boys.
Why waste the money on a haircut when you got that hat?
Good point. Wolfie D and J.C. Ice. Armstrongs, this is a three-way dance for the World Tag Team Championships.
But the Mamalukes, you can't blame them. I mean, they know what happened now. They know the Harris boys tried to bribe these guys to hurt them, to keep them out of the, you know, championship realm here. And, hey, Mamalukes, when these guys lose their tempers, don't mess with them.
Well, I tell you what, you've got four men in that ring in J.C. Ice, Wolfie D, and the Armstrong that are capable of doing this type of damage to the Mamalukes. Last week on this broadcast, the Armstrong jumped the World Tag Team Champion. It was after the matchup, but the Mamalukes held their own. Not only had they been involved in a contest, they cleared house of Scott and Steve Armstrong 1 week ago on this broadcast. They are the World Tag Team Champion. But J.C. Ice and Wolfie D came in, doubled the odds. It was 4-on-2. And this week on Saturday night, we will see if the Armstrongs, J.C. and Wolfie, will earn their money from the Harris boys.
Well, we saw what happened last week, but this is the present. Past does not exist, but the memory of it does. And I tell you, it's been in the hearts and minds of the Mamalukes.
In 8 days, the Mamalukes will defend the World Tag Team Championships against the Harris boys. And remember, they've got the Disco Inferno, that hat you see at the bottom of your screen.
Can't miss that hat.
Wrapped around the enormous head of Disco Inferno, the manager of champions. This is a three-way dance. Anyone can tag anyone, and the World Tag Team Championships are at stake here. We may have new tag team champions. The Harris boys, that's what they want. They want to get a shot at tag team gold from anybody but the Mamalukes. They would rather face the Armstrongs. Hang on. Steve Armstrong, no. Got a two count on Johnny the Bull.
No, he didn't even tag his own brother. But again, like you said, this is the Harris boys trying to get the Mamalukes out of the picture. But it's too late. The cat is out of the bag. The Mamalukes knows what's going on. But it's very easy to lose the belts in this kind of match. The Harris boys don't even have to be in the ring.
That's exactly right. Oh, knee drop from Wolfie D. Steve Armstrong. Oh, into the Boston Crab. And Wolfie D. J.C. Ice and the Armstrongs They're working like a well-oiled machine out there. It is 4-on-2. Oh, Fino!
Well, I think that's one of the secrets. And maybe not so much oil, but definitely way outnumbered.
The Harris boys, hang on a second. Wolfie, oh, Wolfie D just relieved Disco of his hat. Wolfie and Disco, whoa!
Disco nailed him!
Did he ever?
Disco, oh, you got nailed!
J.C. Ice with the hubcap in the study.
Ooh! The study?
Johnny the Bull with a right hand. Doubled up Scott Armstrong. Now, Scott, now see, that's why Johnny the Bull shouldn't wear that shirt in the ring. Scott Armstrong taking advantage, blinding his opponent. The referee trying to get Vito back in the corner. Meanwhile, Johnny the Bull being quadruple teamed by the Armstrongs, J.C. Ice and Wolfie D.
But then you got a lot of bodies in there, only one referee. Again, wearing that shirt in the ring, I mean, guys know they can tie you up with your own shirt. Johnny the Bull finding out the hard way, but at least the shirt's gone. His arms are free to move. Better move over him and get a tag. But he can tag anybody. He can tag the Armstrongs when he's in the corner.
He should. That's exactly right.
But easier said than done when you're getting choked and stretched out like that.
Maybe they don't want to be tagged either. Johnny the Bull really being manhandled by four men. We said 4-on-2. It's 4-on-1. Vito hasn't been involved in this contest legally as of yet. Johnny just bought one right in the throat from Wolfie D. World Tag Team Championships on the line here. A three-way dance. J.C. Ice and Wolfie D, the Armstrongs and the Mamalukes.
And there goes Vito. He's getting hot. He wants to get in there.
The Harris boys spreading around the welt to the Armstrongs, J.C. and Wolfie. All they want is for one of these two teams to take out the Mamalukes and become World Tag Team Champions. That's all they want.
Yeah, and they don't care which one it is either. That the Harris boys figure they're... much more easy pickings than the Mamalukes here.
Vito. Wait a minute, Vito! Vito was trying to pin Johnny the Bull.
Yeah, but that's a great plan.
That's a perfect plan.
They would have won their own belt.
That's right. You realize, of course, that J.C. Ice could pin Steve Armstrong, and J.C. Ice and Wolfie D, they would become World Tag Team Champions. That's the rules of the three-way dance. The Mamalukes don't have to be pinned.
Uh-oh!
There it is! The spinning DDT!
Vito got one in!
Implant DDT on J.C. Ice. Johnny the Bull has what's left of J.C. Look at the balance from Johnny. Up top, J.C. prone in the center. Oh! Leg drop from the top. Hooks the far leg, and it is over.
It's over now, and I will see if the Harris boys are still as confident as they sounded earlier. They were shooting off their mouth, talking about they're walking out with the gold. But it's not going to be easy.
The manager of champions is ecstatic. Disco Inferno, elated. The Mamalukes will retain the World Tag Team title. They will head to Uncensored to defend those belts against the Harris boys. And the Harris boys, they're out several grand trying to throw the green. Hang on a second.
I hope you've enjoyed your run. Because in 8 days, at Uncensored 2000, Heavy D and Big Ron are going to be the new heavyweight tag team champion.
That's not a threat. That sounded just like a fact.
Well, they sound all overconfident to me, but I mean, two guys not happy. They just wasted a lot of cash.
We've got big news. Another match added to this broadcast. Much more still to come. Stay with us.